We'll discuss about cutaneous mycoses. What is cutaneous mycoses? Okay, cutaneous mycoses. Mycoses means it is fungal infection. Fungal infection. Cutaneous means skin. See what is cutaneous mycoses. Cutaneous mycoses refers to infection of keratinized structures. It is cutaneous mycoses, infection of keratinized structure. Keratinized structures. This is causative agent is dermatophytes. Dermatophytes. It may be acute or chronic. Okay. This may be acute or chronic. If take this dermatophytes, the properties are, they are keratophilic. They digest keratin by keratinase enzyme. Okay, keratinase enzyme. Second one is, they do not invade deeper structures. No invasion. Okay, no invasion. And they do not invade deeper structures. One is they, and third one is they are hyaline, they are present hyaline filaments. They are resistant to cycloheximide. Fourth one is resistant to cycloheximide. Okay, we will take another paper. Okay, they are resistant to cycloheximide. They are resistant to cycloheximide. Okay, there are three genera in this dermatophytes. Okay, three genera. One is microsporum. Microsporum. They infect. Microsporum, it infects skin and hair. Okay, skin and hair. It infects skin and hair. Second one is epidermophyton. Epidermophyton, it infects skin and nail. First one is microsporum, second one is epidermophyton, third one is trichophyton. Trichophyton, it infects skin, hair and nail. Okay, these are three genera, and in each genera consists of different species. Okay, we'll take another paper. If you take dermatophyta, if you take microsporum, the species are microsporum. The species are microsporum, gypsum, microsporum, canis, microsporum, nanis. Okay, microsporum, gypsum, microsporum, canis, microsporum, nanis. These are three species under microsporum. Okay, second one is trichophyton. Under trichophyton, we have trichophyton rubrum, trichophyton verrucosum. Third one is trichophyton mentagrophytes. Third one is in epidermophyton, only one species is there. That species is epidermophyton fluccosums. Epidermophyton, we take another sheet. Under epidermophyton, epidermophyton, we have only single species, that is epidermophyton fluccosum. Okay, these are different species. Okay, the clinical aspects of this dermatophytosis is, we'll discuss clinical aspects. We'll take fresh sheet, okay, for this. Clinical manifestation. In clinical manifestation, this dermatophytes is common in female. Ink is common in male, it's not female. Common in male. Okay. Tinea barbae. Okay, first one is Tinea barbae. It infects bad areas. Infection to bad areas. Second one is Tinea imbricata. Tinea corporis. It is infection of smooth or non-hairy skin of body. Smooth or non-hairy region. Region of skin. Okay. Next, Tinea imbricata. It is special type of Tinea corporis. Okay. Tinea imbricata. Tinea imbricata, it is a special type of Tinea corporis, in which it is characterized by concentric rings of papulosquamous scaly patches. They are characterized by concentric rings. Okay. Concentric rings of papulosquamous ring. Papulosquamous scaly patches. Okay, tenia imbricata, it is a special type of tenia corporis. It is characterized by concentric rings of papillosquamous squarely patches. Okay, next we'll move to another manifestation, that is tenia capitis. Tenia capitis. It involves scalp. Okay, it is infection of scalp. The variants are flavus and carrion. These two are the variants of tenia capitis. Okay, variants of tenia capitis are flavus and carrion. What is flavus and carrion? We'll discuss later. Don't worry about this. And next one is tenia cruris. Okay, tenia cruris. It involves groin and perineum. Okay, infection of groin and perineum. Okay, it is also called Jokic. It involves groin and perineum. Tenia pedis. It involves foot. Okay, tenia pedis. It involves foot. It is infection of foot. Okay, it is also called athlete's foot. Tenia pedis also called athlete's foot. Athlete's foot. Athlete's foot. Next one is tenium manum. Tenia manum. It involves hand. Okay, tenia manum means infection of hand, we can say. Okay, next one is tenia anguium. Tenia anguium. It involves nails. Okay, nails are infected in tenia anguinium. Okay, tenia anguinium. It involves nails. Tenia manum, hand. Tenia pedis. It involves foot. Okay, tenia cruris. It involves groin and perineum. Okay, tenia capitis. Scalp is involved. Flavus and carrion are involved. Okay, this is clinical aspects. Clinical features, we'll discuss clinical features. In all these categories, what we see is the lesions in the skin are circular. If we take lesions, how they look is they are circular. The lesions on the skin, these are lesions on skin. Okay, there was circular erythematous itchy lesions. Okay, and they are scaly also. Okay, the lesions on skin are circular, erythematous, itchy, and they are scaly. Okay, if you take in lesions in hair, In hair, the lesions of hair includes carrion. Okay, scarring, scarring, and alopecia. Okay, if they are, if they infect here, there will be carrion, scarring, and alopecia. What is carrion? We'll discuss about carrion. Carrion, it is severe boggy lesion. Okay, severe boggy lesion with marked inflammation. Marked inflammation. There will be marked inflammation. Okay, there will be marked inflammation. Boggy lesions. This usually develop in the scalp. Okay, they develop in the scalp. They are severe boggy lesions in the scalp. We can say there will be marked inflammation. Okay, there will be marked inflammation. So, next to flowers. Flowers, a chronic type of ringworm in which dense crust develop in the hair follicles. Okay, there in the flowers, crust develop in the hair follicle. Okay, there develops crust in the hair follicles. This leads to scarring. This leads to scarring and alopecia. Okay, this leads to scarring and alopecia. This is about flowers. Lesions in nails. What happens when nails are involved in the infection? When nails are involved, the nails are discolored. Okay, the involved nails are discolored. There will be deformity of nails. Deformed nails, there will be deformation in the nails, there will be discoloration of nails, and the nails will be brittle in nature. Okay, the nails will be brittle in nature, and we will also see there is accumulation of debris under nails. Okay, accumulation of debris. There will be accumulation of debris under the nail. Okay, under the nail. This is the involvement of nail. Okay, next we'll move to pathogenicity. How the pathogenicity is seen? Pathogenicity. In pathogenicity, actually the pathogenicity is not known. The fungal products, these are responsible for local itchy inflammatory lesions. Okay, and fungal antigens, these antigens are responsible for vesicular lesions. At distant sites, vesicular lesions at sites distant to the local infection. Okay, at distant sites. Okay, at distant sites. Other than it's, they are not present in the infected areas. They are present somewhere other than the infected areas. This is due to antigens, and we can say it has one of the hypersensitivity to the. We can say it has hypersensitivity to the antigens. Okay, they are vesicular lesions. Okay, actually this is called dermatophytes. This reaction is called dermatophytes. Or ID reactions. So what is ID reaction? What is dermatophytes? They are vesicular lesions that are present away to the local infection. Okay, it is due to mainly antigens. Okay, this is about pathogenicity. Next, we'll move to diagnosis, which involves laboratory diagnosis. Okay, now laboratory investigations. If take first, we'll see the what are the specimens that we need to take. Skin scrapings, nail scrapings. These are specimens. Okay. These nails must be taken from margins. Okay. Third one is skin, nail, and fourth one is from hair, plucked hairs, we can say. These are specimens. Now we'll move to examination. First one is wood lamp examination. Wood lamp examination. See, the infected areas, they are fluorescent. Okay, under wood lamp examination, infected areas are fluorescent. This fluorescence is due to presence of pteridine pigment in cell wall. Okay, this test is positive for microsporum and trichophyton. Okay, they are positive for microsporum species and trichophyton species. Okay, these two, they show positive test for fluorescence. Okay, other epidermophyton, they are negative. Okay, this is about wood lamp examination. Next, we'll move to another examination, that is special direct examination under potassium hydroxide mold. Okay, potassium hydroxide mold. Here we use 10% potassium hydroxide. Okay, potassium hydroxide mold. What we see here is hyaline hype. We'll see septate, hyaline hype. అయిపోయి విత్ ఆర్థోకోడియా విత్ ఆర్థోకోనిడియా ఓకే నెక్స్ట్ కల్చర్ విల్ గో టు కల్చర్ ఇన్ కల్చర్ వాట్ వి సీ ఈస్ బిఫోర్ గోయింగ్ టు కల్చర్ సి వెన్ హెయిర్ ఈస్ ఇన్వాల్వ్డ్ వెన్ హెయిర్ ఈస్ ఇన్వాల్వ్డ్ దేర్ ఆర్ టూ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్ఫెక్షన్ ఓకే వెన్ హెయిర్ ఈస్ ఇన్వాల్వ్డ్ టూ టైప్స్ వన్ ఈస్ ఎక్టోత్రిక్స్ అండ్ ఎండోత్రిక్స్ ఫస్ట్ వన్ ఈస్ ఎక్టోత్రిక్స్ ఎక్టో మీన్స్ అవుట్ సైడ్ సపోజ్ ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ హెయిర్ ఓకే ఆర్థోకొనిడియా దే సరౌండ్ దిస్ హెయిర్ ఫాలికల్ లైక్ దిస్ హెయిర్ షాప్ లైక్ దిస్ దిస్ ఆర్ ఆర్థోకొనిడియా ఓకే దిస్ ఆర్ ఆర్థోకొనిడియా దే విల్ అక్యుములేట్ ఆన్ ద హెయిర్ షాఫ్ట్ లైక్ దిస్ ఓకే దిస్ ఆర్ వాట్ ఆర్థోకొనిడియా they are orthoconidia they accumulate like this okay around hair this is ectothrix second one is I am writing here because space is not there endothrix they are this orthoconidia they are present inside this air shaft suppose this is air shaft they are present inside the air shaft like this these are orthoconidia present in air shaft okay these are two infections of hair okay next we'll move to culture in culture species identification can be done okay what the use of this culture is species identification can be done okay species identification can be done there the media that we use here is one is Sebarat glucose neopentone agar Sebarat glucose neopentone agar this is one medium okay this medium contains chloramphenicol okay we'll add chloramphenicol to this medium what is the use of this chloramphenicol acts as antibacterial okay it kills contaminant bacteria that is the use of this chloramphenicol and second one what we use is second is Sebarat agar, okay? Sebarat, spelling is something mistake, okay? Sebarat agar. In Sebarat agar, we'll mix two drugs. One is chloramphenicol as said before this is antibacterial we'll add one more drug that is cyclohexamide the use of this cyclohexamide is it kills other fungi other than dermatophytes okay it kills other fungi okay other than what dermatophytosis. Okay, this is about culture. Next we'll move to identification of dermatite in examination. Okay, we'll move to identification points. Okay, this color is not good. We'll take one more color. Okay, done. Okay, done. We'll move to identification. Identification. How we identify this? See, macroscopic identification points. Macroscopic identification. It depends on growth, texture, color, and observe. Okay, it depends on color, texture. Okay, it all depends on even growth. Okay, it depends on, based on this we'll identify. Okay, first one is how we identify trichophyton. What are the identification points of trichophyton? How they look macroscopically. Okay, we are discussing about macroscopic points. Trichophyton, the colonies are powdery, velvety, or waxy, with pigmentation characteristic of different species. Okay, pigmentation. This pigmentation is different from species to species. Okay, this pigmentation is useful in species identification of trichophyton. Okay, this is about trichophyton. And coming to microsporum, the colonies are cotton-like, velvety, or powdery, we'll write here, or powdery, with white to brown pigmentation, Okay, white to brown pigmentation. Next, coming to epidermophyton. Epidermophyton, the macroscopic structure is, macroscopically they are powdery and greenish yellow. This is very important. Actually, dermatophyton, it contains only one species, that is epidermophyton fluctuosum. The identification points macroscopically, they are powdery and greenish yellow in color. Greenish yellow. Remember this word, okay, greenish yellow, because this epidermophyton genera, it contains only one species, that is epidermophyton fluctuosum. Okay, epidermophyton fluctuosum. This is about microscopy. Then coming to microscopic appearance. Next, coming to microscopic appearance. Microscopic appearance. Trichophyton. Okay. Trichosporum, microconidia are abundant. Okay, if you take trichophyton, microconidia are abundant. They present more microconidia. and they are arranged along IPA or bone and conduit pores. Okay, these microspores are present either along IPA or present in conduit pores. Okay, they are present either along the IPA or in the conduit pores. This is about trichophyton. Next, coming to microsporum. Microsporum. In microsporum, microconidia are absent. Microconidia, they are absent. Okay, microconidia are absent. Macroconidia are the predominant. Okay, predominantly macroconidia are present. Macroconidia are present. Okay, how they look? This macroconidia, they are spindle shaped. Okay, we'll draw this diagram. Okay, we'll discuss it diagrammatically. We are discussing about microsporum. Predominantly macroconidia are present. This macroconidia are spindle shaped. We'll draw a diagram for this. But first we'll try to discuss it theoretically. Macroconidia are spindle shaped. They are multicellular. Okay, multicellular. Okay, they are very large. Bone at the ends of IPA. Okay, suppose this is IPA. Diagram is not coming. This is IPA. They are spindle shaped and they are present at the ends. Okay, like this. This diagram is not good, but they are present. They are present along the at the ends. Okay, this is IPA. This is spindle shape. Okay, they are present at the ends. Okay, at the ends of conidia, like this they will be. Okay, this is about microsporum. Next, we'll discuss about epidermophyton. Epidermophyton. They are, as said before, they are powdery and greenish and yellow in color. Microconidia are absent. Sorry, I told you that in microconidia are absent, right? But they are present. Microconidia are present, but they are scanty. Okay, I told you that microconidia are absent, but they are present. I am sorry for that. Microconidia are present in microsporum, but they are scanty. Okay, microconidia are absent in epidermophyton. Okay, epidermophyton. In epidermophyton, microconidia are absent. Microconidia are absent. macroconidia, this macroconidia are spear shaped. Okay, this is about microscopic examination, macroscopic appearance. We'll discuss other physiological tests, some other physiological test like in vitro hair penetration test. Air penetration test. Second one is hydrolyzed urea test. Next, based on growth on polished rice grains. Polished rice grain and based on to withstand elevated temperature. And fourth one is based on requirements of some vitamins and amino acids and vitamins and hypersensitivity reactions. We can do skin test also based on skin test also. Okay, this is, and this depend base we'll discuss this dermatophytes under certain headings. Okay, how they are classified. Usually dermatophytes are maybe classified into three types based on their habitat. Okay, these dermatophytes, they are classified, okay, based on habitat into, one is arthrophilic, second one is zoophilic, third one is geophilic. See, the name itself says what is the meaning, what the name itself will says us. See, the arthropedic, artho in the sense human, zoo means animal, geo means earth soil. We'll see about arthrophilic. Humans are the main reservoirs. Humans are the only hosts for arthrophilic. Okay, man is the only host, we can say. Okay, humans are the only hosts to this arthrophilic dermatophytes. Okay, they cause mild but chronic infections. Okay, they are usually resistant to treatment. Okay. Second one is zoophilic. Zoophilic. Okay, the examples of orthophilic are examples. One is examples are trichophyton rubrum. Trichophyton rubrum. Second one is epidermophyton fluccosum. Epidermophyton fluccosum and microsporum adeni. Okay, these three are the examples of what? These three are the examples of orthophilic. Okay, next we'll discuss about zoophilic. We'll discuss in new page. Zoophilic dermatophytes. Okay, these zoophilic dermatophytes, they are natural parasites of animals. Okay, they are natural parasites of animals. Okay, they are natural parasites of animals. They cause acute and severe infection, but they are readily curable. And the examples include zoophilic trichosporum varicosum. They are parasites of cat. Okay, trichosporum cat and dogs. Sorry, trichosporum varicosum, it's a cat. Okay, it's present in cat. This is right. Okay, these varicosums are present in cat. Next one is microsporum canis. Microsporum canis, it infects dogs and cats. Okay, this is about zoophilic. Next, geophilic, which occur naturally in the soil and they are relatively less pathogenic. Okay, next one is zoophilic, they are present in the soil. Okay, they are less pathogenic. Okay, examples include microsporum gypsum and trichosporum agelloi. Okay, this is agelloi. These two are the examples of zoophilic. They are present in the soil. They are less pathogenic. Okay, so how do we control this dermatophytes? How we control personal hygiene. Okay, avoiding contact with infectious material. Treatment for infected people. Okay, you should take treatment to the infected people. We'll discuss few points about Cutaneous pedis. Okay, Cutaneous pedis. We discussed few points about what is Cutaneous pedis. tenapedis, they involve infection of foot. Okay, it usually seen in the people who are wearing shoes. Okay, it usually seen people wearing shoes. Okay, in fact, how it's transmitted from one person to another person is desquamated skin desquamated skin from infected people. This lodges in bathrooms, okay, bathrooms and showers. When the same bathrooms are used by other people, they get infected. Okay, this is how it gets transmitted. First, desquamated skin, it gets dislodged in the bathrooms and showers. When another healthy person, when he takes bath in that same bathroom or washroom, he gets infected from that microorganism. Okay, this is a little bit about dermatophytes. Thank you for watching.